think that I am a Filipino, that I am as good a Filipino as anyone. My heart thrills when I hear the national anthem being played.
And my blood rises when I see our flag fluttering in the breeze.
And yet, I find myself asking, how Filipino am I, really?
My first name is American.
My last name is Chinese.
When I am with girlfriends, or more correctly, when I am with my friends who happen to be girls, I talk to them in English.
If they are thirsty, I buy them a bottle of American Coke.
If they are hungry, I treat them to an Italian pizza pie.
And when I have the money, I give them a real Chinese story.
Considering all this, considering my taste, for many things foreign, what right do I have to call myself a Filipino?
Should I not call myself a culture orphan, the illegitimate child of many races?
Rightly or wrongly, whether we like it or not, we are the end products of our history. Fortunately or unfortunately, our history is a commingling of polyglot influences.
Malayan and Chinese.
Spanish and British.
American and Japanese.
This is historic fact we cannot ignore. A cultural reality we cannot escape. For to believe otherwise is to indulge in fantasy.
I must confess, I am an extremely confused and bewildered young man. Wherever I am, whatever I may be doing, I am bombarded on all sides by people who want me to search for my national identity.
Tell me the language I speak should be replaced by Filipino. They urge me to do away with things foreign, to act and think and buy Filipino.
Even in art, I am getting bothered and bewildered.
The writer should use Filipino as his medium, the nationalist cry.
The painter should use his genius in portraying things purely Filipino, the man.
The composer should exploit endless possibilities of the Huntington demon. They insist. All these sound wonderful, but Rizal used Spanish when he wrote Goli and Fili.
Was he less of a nationalist because of it? Was the artist to be truly Filipino, painted with the juice of Maduwa?
And must he draw pictures of topless Muslim women or Igorot warriors in G-string? And if the composer deserves the condemn, and he writes songs faithful to the spirit of the youth of the day, does he become un-Filipino? We are what we are today because of our history.
In our veins, pulses blood with traces of Chinese and Spanish and American. But it does not stop being because of this.
Our culture is tinged with foreign influences, but it has become rich thereby. This mingling, in fact, could lead us on the road to national greatness. Look at America. It is a great country, and yet it is a melting pot of Italian and German, British and French, or Irish and Swedish.
Filipinism, after all, is in the heart.
If that heart beats faster because the Philippines is making progress, if it feels with compassion because its people are suffering, then it belongs to a true Filipino, and it throbs with pride in our past. If it pulses with awareness of the present, if it beats with the faith in the future, then we can ask for nothing more. All other things are unimportant.
I have an American first name.
And I have a Chinese last name. And I am proud, very, very proud, because underneath these names beats a Filipino heart. The Anatomy of a Filipino by Professor Felix Bautista.